Continuing this, already we have studied about the
classification. Then we have revised about the classification of the diseases. That is, depending upon the different modes, the diseases have been classified into the different categories. And from that categories, number one category, we have also differentiated, that is the diseases which are classified as on the basis of their transmission from the infected person to the normal healthy person. That are called as infectious or non-infectious. Okay. That means the disease can be transmitted from one person to the another. It is infectious or communicable. And the one which cannot be transmitted, that is non-infectious and non-communicable. Done. So coming to the second category of the diseases, if you remember, in the last lecture, we have discussed about the different categories in the form of a flowchart. We have made it. So that I'm going to continue further. So coming to the second category of the diseases, that is depending upon the duration of the disease, how long the disease is there in a human body, for that and how properly it can be recovered, the person can be recovered from that, how this is going to affect your body, that is less effective will be there or more effective is going to be there. So depending upon these factors, these diseases can be classified as acute or chronic diseases. Okay. So number one, what are the differences between the acute and the chronic diseases? Yes, you people raise your hand and give me 1 point each student for the differences between acute and chronic. Yes, 1 second, Eva. And Eva, first point of difference.
Acute diseases are short-term diseases.
Yes, because we are saying that it is on the basis of the duration. So acute are the one which are short-term, very right. And the chronics will be staying there in a human body for a longer period of time, right?
Long duration.
Yes, that is, this is short-term disease. It is called as a short-term disease or that actually stays there for a shorter period of time, right, in the human body. And whereas this chronic, it is going to stay there for longer term. Okay, so this is a long-term disease. Why acute is called as short-term disease and why this chronic is called as long-term? Yes, Rami. Why it is called as short-term and this is long-term?
Because acute diseases has short-term effect on the body and chronic disease have long-term effect on the body.
Justify this. Justify it.
Acute diseases have less damage to body organs and chronic diseases have more damage to body organs.
Yes. That is, the acute diseases, they have the lesser damage to the body organs, whereas the chronics, they give the more damage to the body organs. And this will be your second point also. That is, they have less damage to the body organs, less damage to body organs, that is of humans we are talking about, and they will be having more of the damage is given when the person suffers from chronic disease, right? The next can be its recovery also. You know, this can be also justified by the recovery, that these short-term diseases, they are recovered earlier, means they are more frequently recovered and also they have more chances to be recovered even. Or agar recovery hoti hai, that is 100% recovery. Chronics mein recovery hone ke chances pehle to kam hai. Theek hai? Then second is, agar recovery ho bhi jati hai, that is not going to be the 100% recovery because some or the other side effects are left. Theek hai? So yahan pe ye bhi dono points, aapke next two points jo hai, wo bhi ikatthe hi aayenge. Theek hai? You please lower down your hands, all the students. As I have already spoken out for the points. So this is for the next point, that is 100% recovery is possible in case of acute diseases. 100% recovery is possible, whereas for chronics, 100% recovery is not possible. And this is not possible. Why not possible? Because some of the other side effects will be left within the body. Side effects will be left. Some of the other organs will also suffer with the after this particular disease. When it is over, the disease has been cured to some extent. After that also, there are some of the features that which get suffered still. You get the features like some of the organs. Okay. Whereas here for this, the side effects are not common. That is, the side effects for these diseases will not be much commonly involved. Okay, thank you, Dhiren.
Ma'am, can we write that in acute diseases, there is not much implication, and chronic death is may or may not lead to death.
In chronic, it may or may not lead to death. Are you saying the chronics may or may not lead to death and acute leads to death?
Ma'am, in chronic, it doesn't cause any implications, and in chronic, it may or may not lead to death.
May or may not lead to death, that can be a point of difference, but looking to the today's scenario also, if we say COVID like diseases, they are actually creating just a simple cold, and after that the person is dying, you know. So we can't figure out that the particular disease is leading to the death or not. As accordingly, we should not add this point, because any of the diseases there, we don't know what the disease is going to act in the body, right? So how it is going to be taken in the body, and how it is going to be, how it is going to be cured, then what the other effects it is going to create, right? So we can't even correlate, right? So leading to the death, that is an inevitable truth, right? And that is because of any of the diseases, or not because of any of the diseases, the person was healthier enough. Like there are usually, recently, two or three cases you have heard, that of the good famous personalities, those who were of the younger ages, you know, there were two heroes also, you know, in the list of those people, those who died just in their younger age, and that were the two people, those who were very much frequently going for the health conscious, they were very health conscious, and even they were having a very good, you can say, routine work, that is going to the gyms and doing the exercises, whole workout, everything. And also they were not having any particular bad habits. They were not suffering from certain disease also, but still they were caught by the, you can say, heart attacks and all. So this can be also a problem. So leading to death, that is only for chronics, or not for the chronics, for acute, that can't be matched, right? So we should not write a point of this leading to death. According to the law's nature, one who has taken the birth has to die also, right? So can't be connected to the disease, either of the diseases, or disease, any disease. Healthy conditions may also lead to that. That depends. Okay. That depends. Right. So don't write that point. I already told you that to write the points, those which are not having any controversial studies further. Right. So why not to just add on those points which are 100% true to those particular diseases. Right. If even in a particular point you are thinking like, possibly, maybe 100% recovery is not possible in a few of the acute diseases. Okay, let's say the possible 100% is not a recoverable, conditions are not possible. Then here also you will be creating, you can create an instance like simply saying that it may cause 100% recovery. And mostly it causes 100% recovery. You can add on this. Mostly means the words, these type of the words, they cover up the portion of the controversies, right? So write the things smartly. If there are certain controversial answers or the points, so you can add on these points, okay? Accordingly, okay? So acutes may, they are short-term diseases. They are having the less damage to the body organs. 100% recovery is possible. Side effects are not there. And so they are cured much, earlier as compared to the chronics. They are not cured much earlier. Or otherwise, we can say that the curing is, we have written here that 100% recovery is not possible. Na? So means the same, that is, cure may not lead to the 100% cure, right? And so is this acute. Acute may 100% cure is possible. And the person that totally gets rid of the particular disease. But here again, the chances are that the particular organism is going to attack the body again in the lifespan. And then, toh wapis phir se, jaise common cold examples acute. तो उसमें हम क्या कहेंगे कि एक बार डिजीज हो गया, बंदा ठीक हो गया अच्छे से, ठीक है, रिकवरी अच्छे से पॉसिबल हो गई. आफ्टर दैट फॉर मंथ्स द पर्सन डज नॉट गेट एनी कॉमन कोल्ड, राइट? फॉर इयर्स द पर्सन डज नॉट गेट एनी common cold. And is it possible that for the lifelong the person is not going to get the common cold? No. You know, it's a possibility. Some or the other time it is going to get the attack of the same virus again that is causing the common cold. You know, so these type of diseases, they are common and they will be frequently occurring also in the particular person. And it may, again, it is again the chances that it may frequently occur or it may not. And for some diseases, they may frequently occur like common cold. Some of the diseases, they may not. Right. So this is acute and this is chronic. So basically, the possible 4 points are these, along with the examples. Now, raise your hand for the 2 examples of acute type. Yes. Acute diseases. Rameek is done. Arshpreet, you tell me. Dhirin is also done.
Yes, ma'am. For acute diseases, diarrhea, common cold, cough.
Common cold, cough is there and the diarrhea is there, yes. So these are the simple and very acute type of the diseases in which all the recovery is also possible. Side effects are also not left. Damages to the body organs are also very less. And also these are for a short period of time and with medicine, they can be just gone off. Okay, matlab ye inko theek kiya ja sakta. So common cold is there, coughing is there, and other you said diarrhea. Right, very nice. And the other students, Panika, you tell me about the chronic diseases, 2 chronic diseases.
Typhoid, TB, dengue.
TB, dengue, yes. Chikungunya, malaria, etc. etc.
Elephant.
There are a number of diseases that can be counted as for chronic diseases. So typhoid is there. For TB, do not write TB, okay? It is just a short form common name that which is given to the people. You write here full name, that is tuberculosis. Okay. Even in the exams, you people have written TB. Firstly, I was going to cross it, but then I thought TB is also okay. But you should not use the short forms. Okay. If you know the full name, you must write that. That gives a good impact. So typhoid is there, tuberculosis is there. Then other diseases like that of the cancers, that which are the deadly diseases and the chronic diseases, which do not have the recovery possible even. 100% recovery, it is again to cover up our controversial statements. No recovery is possible. So that is only for certain diseases like cancer. For the other diseases, like these diseases are there, the person who suffers gets treated and gets recovered as well. ठीक है वो बात की बात है कि बॉडी के अंदर उसके इफेक्ट्स रह जाते हैं वीकनेस रह जाता है ठीक है जैसे डेंगू चिकनगुनिया में तो आप लोगों ने सुना है दैट द पर्सन दैट यूजुअली गेट्स अ पेन इन द बोन्स है ना द बोन्स बोन एक्स जो है वो यूजुअल हो जाती है फॉर द पर्सन एंड द फटीगनेस इज अ कॉमन फीचर फॉर दोज पीपल सो दैट इज दीज आर द साइड इफेक्ट्स अकॉम्पनीड बाय दीज पर्टिकुलर डिजीजेस बिकॉज दे आर वेरी हार्ड डिजीजेस मीन्स बहुत मतलब बहुत ज्यादा मुश्किल बड़ी बड़ी डिजीजेस है जो ठीक हो गई हैं, ओके है विद द गुड लक ऑफ द पर्सन बट आफ्टर दैट दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू बी फुली द पर्सन इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी फुली रिकवर फ्रॉम दिस ओके सो दैट इज इट इज द क्रॉनिक डिजीजेस एनीथिंग यू वांट टू आस्क दोज़ हु आर रेजिंग द हैंड रने अनिका रमी इफ यू आर रेजिंग योर हैंड्स फॉर द आंसर्स देन इट इज ओके यू वांट टू आस्क एनीथिंग यू स्टिल कीप ऑन रेजिंग योर हैंड्स हां जी रने
मैम टाइफाइड तो अक्यूट होना चाहिए ना क्योंकि वो 7 से 10 days के लिए ही होता है
उसके बाद उसका इफेक्ट नहीं रहता उसका इफेक्ट रहता है बॉडी के अंदर है ना और फिर उसके बाद उसमें जो सिम्टम्स हैं दे आर लाइक जस्ट गॉन ऑफ लेकिन उसके बाद उसके जो कहते हैं प्रिवेंटिव मेजर्स जो है बहुत सारी लगा दी जाती है आफ्टर दैट ऑल्सो फॉर मंथ्स द पर्सन हैज टू टेक केयर अगेन फॉर हिमसेल्फ राइट
मैम ये पॉइंट लिखना कि ट्रीटमेंट विल लीड टू क्योर इन एक्यूट डिजीजेस वेयर एज इन क्रॉनिक ट्रीटमेंट मे और मे नॉट क्योर द डिजीज
यस यू कैन राइट दिस ट्रीटमेंट गिव्स 100% क्योर इन दिस एक्यूट क्योर इज पॉसिबल सो वी कैन से दैट विद ट्रीटमेंट्स विद मेडिसिंस द पर्सन कैन गेट द रिड ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर डिजीज यू कैन राइट दिस पॉइंट एड ऑन दिस पॉइंट एंड फॉर क्रॉनिक्स बेसिकली दिस treatments that may not always give the fruitful results theek hai treatments may only prolong jaise abhi humne ek example liya aids hai cancer hai wo to bahut hi badi badi diseases hai na
तो अब इनमें क्या है, अगर आप ये दोनों भी लिख दोगे तो 100% आपका ये कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल, जैसे अभी प्रणय ने बोला टाइफॉइड वाला कंडीशन, तो इसमें भी कई बार ये बहुत ज्यादा सिवियर हो जाता है टाइफॉइड, है ना, तो सिवियर कंडीशंस में तो इट इज वेरी प्रोलॉन्ग एंड ऑल्सो वेरी अनक्योरेबल टाइप्स भी हो जाता है, ठीक है। ओके, कमिंग टू दिस, एड्स है, कैंसर है, तो ऐसी वाली जो डिजीजेस हैं दे आर द वेरी क्वाइट लॉन्ग डिजीजेस एंड ऑल्सो ट्रीटमेंट पॉइंट जो दिया अभी आपने बोला उसमें ट्रीटमेंट में यहाँ ट्रीटमेंट दिया जाता है जस्ट ओनली टू प्रोलॉन्ग द पर्सन्स लाइफ, है ना, दैट इज टू डिले द डेथ वी कैन से, राइट, ओनली फॉर दैट पर्पज, अदरवाइज द ट्रीटमेंट दे आर नॉट बेसिकली गोइंग टू ट्रीट इट 100%, राइट, अगेन द थिंग कम्स दैट इज द डेथ इज इनएविटेबल ट्रुथ, दैट इज इट हैज टू बी फेस्ड बाय एनी ऑफ द पर्सन, maybe healthy, maybe suffering with a small disease that is acute, or maybe suffering with a good heart disease that is a chronic disease, to ho sakta hai kaisa bhi death ho, but it is death is there, right, but treatment point you can add, so treatment is not giving the 100% cure in the chronics, whereas the treatment possibly gives 100% cure in the acute diseases. Okay, so these are the few points of the acute and the chronic. Anything else you want to add on or you want to discuss about? Yes. Okay. So now coming to the next, that is the further third category of the diseases that we studied in the last lecture, that are congenital and acquired diseases. Congenital and the acquired diseases. So what are these congenital and the acquired diseases? As the very first difference will be its definition only. What are the congenital diseases? The diseases that the person gets from the birth, by birth, right? So these are the diseases that the person gets, diseases that a person gets by birth. Okay, at the time of the birth of a child, a new organism, if the child is already suffering with some of the syndromes, or if it is already suffering with some of the disease which was there in the parents also, then that type of a disease is called as a congenital disease. Okay, now acquired are those diseases which a person gets in the lifespan, for example these types of the diseases. Okay, so that is acquired are those the diseases that a person gets during अगर मैं इसको सिंपल कोरिलेशन देती हूँ विद द फीचर्स, से योर सम ऑफ द फीचर्स देवर द फीचर्स दैट आर गिवन बाय द पेरेंट्स, राइट, some of the features you will see that they are similar to your parents, like maybe your physique is similar to your parents, maybe your look is similar to your parents, or sometimes the eyes, they matches with the father parent, and the way of speaking or standing, and the things like physiological functioning jo hamari, that is matching to the mother parent, hai na, to ye kya hai, ye features hain hame jo genetically mile hain, ye disease ki baat nahi main kar rahi hu, main simple features ki baat kar rahi hu. तो फीचर्स अगर मैं सिंपल में बात करूं तो वो भी दो तरह के होते हैं हमारे पास. एक तो वो वाले फीचर्स जो हमें मिलते हैं पेरेंट्स से, पेरेंटल, ठीक है. एक होते हैं फीचर्स जो आप खुद एक्वायर करते हो, लाइक दे आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द वन यू गॉट फ्रॉम योर पेरेंट्स, ठीक है. से अ पर्सन इज, यू कैन से अ पर्सन हैज लर्न अ न्यू टाइप ऑफ द कैलीग्राफीज, ओके, कैलीग्राफिक स्किल्स अगर उसने सीखी है, या हैंड राइटिंग उसका डिफरेंट है, ठीक है. पेरेंट्स की हैंड राइटिंग बहुत अच्छी नहीं थी, लेकिन द चाइल्ड हैज वर्कड ऑन एंड द चाइल्ड इज पॉसिबली इम्प्रूविंग द स्किल ऑफ हैंड राइटिंग, सिंपली सेइंग दिस, ठीक है. छोटी सी एक बात मैंने कही कि हमने क्या है, हैंड राइटिंग सीख लिया, मेरे पेरेंट्स में अगर हैंड राइटिंग अच्छा नहीं था पर मैंने अच्छा सा सीख लिया. सो वॉट इज दैट पर्टिकुलर स्किल, वॉट इज दैट पर्टिकुलर फीचर, द वन विच आई हैव एक्वायर्ड विद माई एफर्ट्स, है ना. दैट इज इफ द पर्सन इज एक्वायरिंग सम ऑफ द फीचर्स which are not given by the parents, but you are acquiring it on your own, means that are the acquired features. Say the person's parents, they did not know even how to swim, and and the child was a very good swimmer. ठीक है, child जो है वो बहुत अच्छा swimmer बन जाता है, वो gold medalist बन जाता है swimmers में, या कोई भी और आप लोगों ने कोई game सीखा जो आपके parents को नहीं आता था, मीन्स वॉट, पेरेंट्स के अंदर वो फीचर नहीं था, आपको वो नहीं मिला, लेकिन आपने एक्वायर किया, ठीक है। सो फीचर वाइज भी अगर हम इसको कंसिडर करें तब भी हमारे पास दो तरह के फीचर्स होते हैं, एक जो जेनेटिकली मिलते हैं हमें पेरेंट्स से और एक होते हैं जो हम खुद एक्वायर करते हैं। अब इन दोनों फीचर्स में ही मैं सिर्फ आपसे पूछना चाहती हूँ कि जो जेनेटिकली मिले या जो एक्वायर किए, उन दोनों में से कौन से फीचर्स ऐसे होंगे जो जेनेटिकली कोड होके आए हैं आपके पास आपके पेरेंट्स से। जेनेटिकली कोड मीन्स जो डीएनए के थ्रू या गेमीट्स के थ्रू, सेलुलर ट्रांसमिशन के थ्रू, क्रोमोसोमल ट्रांसमिशन के थ्रू, इनहेरिटेंस के थ्रू पेरेंट्स से आपके अंदर आए, कौन से ऐसे फीचर्स हैं जो पेरेंट्स से आपके पास आए हैं लेकिन वो क्रोमोसोम्स से आए हैं। अगर हैंडराइटिंग पेरेंट्स, देखो पेरेंट्स भी तो कुछ ना कुछ तो लिखते ही थे ना, कैसा भी लिखते थे कुछ तो लिखते ही थे, तो फीचर है, लेकिन आपने उसको चेंज करके कुछ अलग सीखा, क्या वो जेनेटिकली आपको मिला था या वो जो आपको ऑलरेडी पेरेंट्स से मिला है वो जेनेटिकली डीएनए के ऊपर कोड होके मिला है। हाँ जी दिया
मैम, आई कलर, स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ हेयर,
द फीचर्स दैट वी ऑलरेडी गॉट फ्रॉम द पेरेंट, लाइक दैट आवर फीचर्स है ना, जो फीचर्स हमें यूजुअली हमारे मैच करते हैं, ठीक है। अदर थिंग्स दैट आर द फिजियोलॉजिकल फंक्शनिंग्स, दे आर ऑब्टेन्ड as differently as they are acquired. So can we say the acquireds are also having the coding on the genes? Yes, Dhiren. Can we say? Where is Dhiren? Anji Dhiren. Can we say this?
Yes. Ma'am, acquired features में जैसे कि we use हम उसको खुद ही refine करते हैं, तो फिर मेरे हिसाब से वो हम उसको थोड़ा refine करते हैं, तो शायद वो हम parents acquired नहीं करते।
जो पेरेंट्स से मिला था बाय बर्थ, एट द टाइम ऑफ द बर्थ मिला था, वो जीन्स में ऑलरेडी कोड होके इन्फॉर्मेशन हमारे में मिल गई है, एंड सो वी हैव गॉट अवर फीचर्स, है ना। हमारे फीचर्स जो है वो सिमिलर टू अवर पेरेंट्स होते हैं, हाइट वगैरह का फीचर भी होता है जो हम कहते हैं कि अगर पेरेंट्स टॉल हैं तो चिल्ड्रन भी टॉल होंगे, ऐसा वाला फीचर्स है ना। सो दे आर द फीचर्स दैट वी अटेंड फ्रॉम द पेरेंट्स एंड दे वर कोडेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द डीएनए, राइट। बट वॉट अबाउट द एक्वायर्ड, बिकॉज वी हैव अचीव्ड देम इन द लाइफ स्पैन एंड व्हेन द पर्सन डाइज दोज आर खत्म, ठीक है, वो खत्म हो जाएंगे, है कि नहीं। तो जो फीचर्स हम एक लाइफ टाइम में अचीव करते हैं वो वहीं खत्म भी हो जाते हैं, उस लाइफ के साथ साथ वो खत्म हो जाते हैं, वो आगे भी ट्रेवल नहीं करेंगे। अगर कोई चाइल्ड बहुत ज्यादा अच्छे से मेहनत कर रहा है, उसके पेरेंट्स में नहीं करी है, लेट्स से हम कोई भी एग्जाम्पल लेते हैं, फेमस पर्सनैलिटीज की एग्जाम्पल लेते हैं, we take the example of the Sundar Pichai, ठीक है। उन्होंने क्या किया, जो former है वो अपने Google के है ना, तो उनमें उन्होंने क्या किया, he has worked a lot, maybe उसके parents जो है वो हमें known नहीं है, तो parents उनके क्या है, they are not very good, you can say in the studies or very intelligent in the computer minds, ऐसा कुछ नहीं था, लेकिन इस बच्चे के अंदर था। अब जरूरी नहीं है कि उसके वही वाले फीचर्स, यानी उसके इंटेलिजेंसी वाला फीचर जो है वो आगे उसके फर्दर जनरेशन में जाएगा, है ना। सो दैट इज अ फीचर दैट विच हैज बीन एक्वायर्ड बाय द वर्क ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर पर्सन ड्यूरिंग द लाइफ टाइम, सॉरी ड्यूरिंग द लाइफ टाइम, ओके। सो दिस इज द टू टाइप्स ऑफ द फीचर्स एंड सो आर द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द टू टाइप्स ऑफ द डिजीजेस ऑल्सो। दीज डिजीजेज आर कोडेड ओवर द जीन्स एंड दैट मे ऑल्सो कंटिन्यू इन जनरेशन, ये आगे भी जाएंगी क्योंकि ये ऑलरेडी जीन्स पे कोड होके आएंगी, यहीं पे खत्म नहीं हो जाएंगी, उस पर्सन की डेथ के साथ खत्म नहीं हो जाएंगी जहां पे ये शुरुआत हुई थी। सो दीज आर द डिजीजेस, जनरल आर द डिजीजेस विच हैव देयर कोडिंग ऑन, कोडेड ऑन डीएनए। डीएनए इज अवर जेनेटिक मटीरियल, ओके, डीएनए कैपिटल्स में लिखना, एंड दीज आर नॉट कोडेड ओवर द डीएनए, नॉट कोडेड ओवर डीएनए, गॉट इट। अब आप इनको फीचर्स के साथ याद रखोगे तो बहुत इजीली आप इनको याद रख पाओगे, क्रैमिंग नहीं करना पड़ेगा। एंड सेकेंडली जो कंजेनिटल फीचर्स या डिजीजेस भी हमें मिली हैं, तो अगर ये कोई कंजेनिटल बाय बर्थ दैट इज फ्रॉम पेरेंट्स मिली हैं, तो दे आर ऑल्सो गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू इन द जनरेशंस। दोज डिजीजेस हो सकता है नेक्स्ट जनरेशन में आए, जरूरी नहीं है कि वो आएंगी ही आएंगी, कुछ डिजीजेस होती है वो रिसेसिव होती है, ठीक है, तो वो बहुत मतलब वेरी लेस चांसेस, लाइक 1 out of 10,000 पीपल will be suffering from this, ठीक है, तो कितनी सारी generations निकल जाएंगी 10,000 में, ठीक है। So this is not necessarily that every generation is going to get this congenital disease, okay? So whatever the condition is, but they have been coded on the DNA and they may be further transmitted to the next generations also. They may continue in next generation. मैंने may क्यों लिख दिया अभी? That is because क्योंकि next generation में आ सकती है, लेकिन हो सकता है और आगे कहीं ना कहीं तो आएगी पक्का. ठीक है, may continue in the next generation. ठीक है, और through generations. ठीक है, ये भी लिख दो, और through generations this is going to continue, whereas this is not going to continue. This does not continue for generations. ठीक है, this is every time a person has to acquire a particular disease during the lifespan and will only be given, will only be the sufferer, will only be that particular generation's organism. Next generation or the next organisms will not be the ones which will be given the this particular disease acquired, which will be suffering from this acquired disease. Okay, so what are these diseases? That are the congenital and the acquired diseases. Hanji, Dhiren, yes. Now you
ma'am, if
Hanji, Hanji, bolo, bolo.
Ma'am, if disease infectious नहीं होती तो फिर हम infectious और infectious का word लिख सकते हैं।
हाँ बिल्कुल, acquired मैंने ये तो नहीं कहा कि infectious नहीं होती है, non-infectious होती है। मैंने ये इतना कहा सिर्फ कि ये during the lifetime आती है, आगे इनकी आप categories बना सकते हो, during the lifetime में आगे spread हो सकती है कि नहीं हो सकती, तो उसके हिसाब से infectious non-infectious है। जो acquired की गई है अब उनमें वो 100% curable है या नहीं है वो भी आप condition लगा सकते हैं। ठीक है, until and unless they are not coded over the DNA. अब जैसे AIDS में एक condition है, सिर्फ एक AIDS ऐसी disease है जो कि a person may get during the lifespan. That is during the lifespan मिलती है, लेकिन उसमें एक condition ये भी होता है उसके transmission का, when the infected mother is giving that to the fetus, है ना? But it is not coded over the genes. Genes के ऊपर code नहीं हुआ था, वो तो blood transfusion की वजह से होता है कि blood mother का infected था और जो child के अंदर blood जा रहा है same ही होता है, तो इसलिए फिटस के अंदर वो ब्लड चला गया तो एड्स उसको भी हो गया, है ना? बट वहां दो जनरेशन आ गई, एक मदर जनरेशन एक चाइल्ड जनरेशन, तो उसमें आपने ये कंफ्यूज नहीं करना, एड्स को ये कंफ्यूज नहीं करना कि दैट इज टू जनरेशन एंड दैट इज व्हाई वी आर सेइंग कि इट इज अ कंजेनिटल टाइप. नो, ओके, इट इज एक्वायर्ड इम्यूनो डेफिशिएंसी सिंड्रोम, है ना? सो एक्वायर्ड, इट इज एक्वायर्ड टाइप, नॉट द कंजेनिटल टाइप, वेदर ऑफ दिस केस ऑल्सो बट नॉट द कंजेनिटल. ओके, सो दिस इज वॉट, दिस इज द कंडीशन that the diseases will be given to the next generations, that is congenital and not they are the acquired. So the examples of congenital can be, yes, raise your hands for the examples of congenital diseases. Be quick. Anji Ramni.
Ma'am, anemia, diabetes.
Diabetes is there. Anemia. Anemia. Sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia.
Yes,
sick. Okay, sickle cell anemia, not the anemia usual. Hanji, for acquired. Who else has raised the hand? Again, Dhiren and Diya always, huh? Hanji, Diya. Better tell the
common cold. Common cold, typhoid.
Very nice. So, कोई भी disease है, acute, chronic में या infectious, non-infectious में, you can add all these in the acquired. Right, for congenitals you can write the diseases like sickle cell anemia, जिसका concept मैंने आपको पीछे समझाया था, and the second disease you said was diabetes also. Okay, so these are some of the diseases that can be congenital. Otherwise there are also certain syndromes which are congenital. ठीक है, I'll be discussing about the syndromes in the upcoming lectures. So thank you so much. God bless you all. Your time is also over.